day, good afternoon, and good night, ladies and gentlemen. We are back with another review. Give me one second. All right. We are back with another review, and this time it's going to be Freddy versus Jason. Jason. Anyways, I got this guy like 2 days ago. I just haven't made a video yet. Anyways, Freddy versus Jason. It is Jason. They do not have, they don't have a Freddy. I looked online. I didn't see any Freddy. But I do have a Freddy to compare it with. Alrighty then. Well, let's take a look at the packaging, shall we? Like always, we got Freddy versus Jason with a nice view of side view of Jason Voorhees staring off to the left. And then we come to the side, we have Jason with Freddy versus Jason NECA Real Toys. Then on the back side, you have a few reference photos. We got Freddy versus Jason right there. I hate that. I can't really do that, can I? Freddy versus Jason. Freddy Krueger and Jason Voorhees return to terrorize the teenage population. Except this time, they're out to get each other too. Interesting. I remember watching this movie when I was younger. And whenever I did, it wasn't too bad. I actually enjoyed it. Jason looks cool. And then on this side, we have the same photo on the last side. Jason. And so, why is it wobbly like that? Why? It don't want to stay. It don't want to stay. Anyway, let's take a look at the top. Freddy versus Jason. NECA. And warning. Choking hazard. Not for children under 3 years. Ages 17 and up. Wow. And then you got Jason right there, actually. That's cool. And then at the bottom, barcode. And NECA. And everything else, directed stuff. All right, let's take a look inside, shall we? There you have him, another reference photo on the side, like they always do. And then there he is, inside the packaging. He comes with a few accessories. Two masks, one teddy bear, two machetes, and a fire flame. A fire flame, that doesn't sound like the right grammar. But anyways, there you have it. And let's get him out of the packaging. Alright, there he is out of the side of the packaging. And first things first, take a look at the backdrop. You know, pretty cool actually. I like it. It's the forest, you know? Camp Crystal Lake Forest. But we never use these, so... Alrighty then, there he is, outside of the packaging, and you can't really see his accessories. Here, you know what? Boom. Boom. This isn't the greatest view, I am sorry. You know, you'll see them. Anyways, first things first, let's take a look at all of this accessory. Let's first take a look at Teddy Bear. Teddy Bear, I'm Mr. Teddy Bear. I can cuddle you. But I'm only for Jason, so you ain't getting me. Anyways, nice detail. It looks like there's a little bit of stuffing, or is that just discolor? Not sure. I'm going to say stuffing. Yeah, it's definitely stuffing, because you can see it coming out of the other spots. It's got a few spots with stuffing out of them. There's the back, the little butt, nice tail. The ears actually a little bit bent back, which I kind of like. It's nice detail. And the eyes are pitch black. It's a good, nice brown. A nice, dirty, very dirty brown. Like it's been played with stuff, you know. But it's funny, I don't remember him having a teddy bear in the movie. I don't remember that. Anyways, let's take a look at his machetes. His famous machetes. First, we have a clean version. A nice steel color. It is like a metal, run-down metal. Not rusted, but run-down. And that looks nice. It's got a nice little grip style going to it. It looks like a sword, kind of, you know? Just a straight-up sword. This ain't no machete. It's a sword. Shing, 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 shing.
And then there's the other machete with a little bit of blood on it. As if it doesn't look like it was slash. It doesn't look like slash. It looks like shing, sly, driving it on someone's throat or something, you know, like that, but without the whole blade going in. You guys get what I'm saying? Cool. Now, since we're on the machete topic, let's bring out what goes with the machete, which is the flames. This, I remember this scene very clearly, and you just put it in like that. Ooh, that fits in well. Oh my god, that is cool. That honestly looks really cool. This is from the teenage party scene. The teenage party scene where Jason is looking for Freddy and he gets beer thrown onto him. And his machete has beer, of course, and lights on fire because something happened. I don't remember, flamethrower or something. Anyways, that's that. And it looks cool. Honestly, it's a really nice, I really like it a lot, because then you have it up like this. Yeah. Anyway, set that to the side. Let's take a look at the mask now. The masks are very nice. This one is the Freddy versus Jason mask, with the slashes going through, as if Freddy's claws were, slash his mask, you know? And it's a really nice detail. In the back of all of the masks, it has the circle, which not all of the other Jasons don't have this. So, yeah. And I don't know when this movie would have taken place. I'll talk about that more in a sec. Anyways, beautiful detail. I love the slash in it. It looks great. There's the back, and it's not too discolored like the other Jason that we have, Jason Part 7. I'm pretty sure that one is discolored. I'll show you guys him in a bit. And then we have the bloody mask, which I enjoyed this one a lot. This whole thing is just blood. Just pure violent. And it looks amazing. Same thing with the back. That little loop. This thing. Dude, this thing's scary, honestly. It's pretty cool. Well, now that we've checked out all the accessories, I think it's time to check out Jason himself. Ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch-ch. So, I'm going to move the camera. I picked up the whole stand. Okay, that stand is now with the camera. Alright, first things first. Looks. Jason looks amazing. Now, this thing does come out a little bit, but I don't know how to fix it. It's rubber. It's a hard, not hard, but soft rubber. Great detail. Something that I found interesting is his shirt inside. You guys can't really see it, but it's blue. His body is blue. Here. Yeah. And yes, that was my closet. Pants are completely black, and he does have some bigger, he's got a couple inches on him, okay? Couple inches. From the back, very nice detail. That looks like, his jacket's been ripped, you know? Very beautiful. There's the back of his head. Ew! Oh, there we go. What is that? Oh, that is his hair. I think that's his hair. I need to set you guys back down. These videos are always like super but low budget. I ain't got no budget. Literally all of this is free except the figure. Let's take the mask off. Simply comes off. And the mask looks amazing. Dirty, but clean at the same time. And there's his ugly face. And it looks like he has like sharper teeth or something. I don't know. His face doesn't. So this is what gets me. isn't Freddy versus Jason after like he's messed up way before Freddy versus Jason comes out. So is this like supposed to be before or after? Because his face is way too nice to be after part 7, you know? And let's see how he looks with a different mask. Let's see. Let's do the blood. And it just slides on like any other mask. Oh, hello. Give me one sec. Oh my. Okay, I think I got it. It looks right. But his eyes aren't really lined up with the holes, I think. Huh. Alright, so yeah, that's how you put the mask on. I assumed that you guys knew that already. Oh, weird. They're a little bit oval. Weird. Okay. Anyways, let's take a look at articulation. Now, the articulation for this guy is kind of interesting. I'll show you what I mean in a bit. First, the feet. You can go back just a tiny bit, you know, boom. You can definitely turn it all the way around, 360 degrees, I think it's called. And then the legs bend just at that point. And you can go forward, and his joints go forward, back, splits. Oh my god. Very tough, but he can do the splits. I don't know if it's supposed to make that noise. He does swivel at the waist, and he does can and bend down. Bend over. It's actually pretty cool. Hands go out that far. Wow. See? Here, let's have him do the T-pose from Fortnite. There you go, he's doing the T-pose. Sorry about the fall. I'll edit that out. Elbow, 90 degrees. Hand, can't really bend side to side, but it can swivel. And then here's the weird part. I need a higher thing. Really? Here's the weird part. His neck moves with him. That's what caught me off guard. Alright, let me show you guys how he puts machete in. He doesn't come with any hands, so there's no need to show that. But simply, you come over here, right? And you actually just stick it in. Boom. There you go. And there, that just looks cool. I'm sorry, this guy holding that? You're dead, dude. His machete's on fire. You are going nowhere. Just accept it. Now it's time for his teddy bear, because his teddy bear goes in this hand, and it just goes in like that. It doesn't go in very well, but he holds it. And actually, he holds it pretty well. There you go. And yeah. Now, time for measurements and comparison, which I almost always forget to do that. Alright, first, let's do the measurements. Now, I don't have my crappy old tape measure. Instead, I got this sewing tape measure, and from what it looks like, he is just 7.5. Actually, Almost. Nope, I'm doing this wrong. He is 8 feet tall. Not 8 feet, 8 inches. Oh my god, my comparison fell. So he's just about, because you want to do it right there. Yeah, boom. So yeah, he is 8 inches tall. And then let's have him compare with two characters that you guys should be very known for, except one. But this guy really knows this one character very well. That would be Freddy Krueger. Boom. So there you go. Freddy is much shorter than Jason. And here comes the other Jason, which I just popped his leg out. Oops. Hold on. There you go. Pops it right back in. Chiropractor. Oh, that is not in. Okay, I got the leg back in. But he doesn't he has a wide spread. Actually, Lord have mercy. He's taller. He's Jason Voorhees from Freddy vs. Jason is taller than both of them. That is extremely crazy. So, Freddy stands at about 7.5. Jason stands about Freddy versus Jason 8, and then 7 and 7.5. Wait, you telling me Jason and Freddy are the same height? You telling me these guys are No, they're not the same height. Something's wrong here. Oh, well. Anyways, Freddy versus Jason is much taller than both of them either way. So I guess he would be... I mean, that's also got to do with his inches on the feet, right? Like, come on. There's no way. But who knows? Great movies they are. Well, there you guys have it. Jason Voorhees. Vicious. Vicious? Vicious. Vicious killer. Thank you guys for watching, and I hope you guys have a great day. So, have a good day. Good afternoon and good night, ladies and gentlemen. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace.